The next type of relationship is called as many-to-many relationship. It is many-to-many relationship. Relationship. Okay. So what is many-to-many relationship? Is that many-to-many relationship is generally represented by M ratio N. And here let me do one thing. Let me take an example of many-to-many relationship and let me explain to you with that particular example. Assuming that the example is like this. Every employee is supposed to work on at least one project, and employee can work on many project, and employee can work on many projects, okay. Similarly, an project can have many employees, and every project is supposed to have at least one employee. Okay, so you can represent it with this relation diagram. So this is representing the employee, this is representing the relation which is works on, and this is representing the relation which is project. So this is representing employee, this is works on, and this is the project. So we may be having some employees like employee A1, employee A2, employee E3, employee E4, employee E5, E6, E7, E8, and E9. In the same way, we are having some projects: project P1, project P2, project P3, project P4, project P5, project P6, and project P7. These are the projects which we have. Now they're saying every employee is supposed to work on at least one project. An employee can work on many projects. In the same way, a project can have many employees, and every project to have supposed to have at least one employee. So you can clearly see what is happening here: at least and many. So you can imagine it like this: every employee is supposed to work on at least one project, right? For example, employee E1 is working on the project P1, right? An employee can work on many projects, assuming that employee E1 can also working on project P3, employee E2 working on the project P1, employee E3 is working on the project P2, employee E4 working on the project P3, employee E5 working on the project P1, employee E6 working on the project P4, employee E7 working on the project P7, employee E8 working on the project P4, and employee E9 working on the project P7. Assume it like this. Okay. Why I'm drawing like this? Because of the requirement analysis or requirement statements which we got. That is, every employee is supposed to work on at least one project. So you can see every employee is working on at least one project, and an employee can work on many projects. Like you can see employee E1 is working on more than one project. Make it like this. We have employee E5 is also working on the project P4, right? So E5 and the employee E1, they are working on more than one projects. And similarly, a project can have many employees, like project P1, project P2, project P4, project P7, they are having many employees, and every project is supposed to have at least one employee. Every project is supposed to have at least one employee. That means if there are some projects like we have project P6, P5, this should have at least one employee. Assuming that employee E4 is working on the project P5 and employee E6 is working on the project P6. So you can see every project is supposed to have at least one employee. Okay, now you can give the cardinality ratio and the participation representation. What is the cardinality of employee? That means what is the maximum number of relationship an entity can participate? The employee can participate in more than one relationships, therefore it is N. And what is the participation of employee? That means an employee should work on at least one project, so it is 1. So because every employee is supposed to work on at least one project. In the same way, if we ask what is the cardinality of project, cardinality is what is the maximum number of relationship an entity can participate, here it is many. And what is the participation of project? Participation is 1. And the degree of this relationship works for is, degree is 2. Okay, now you can give all the three representation, that is min-max representation, single line, double line representation, and the participation, or against the cardinality ratio representation. So let me draw it in the same page here. So this is representing an employee, this is the project, again an employee, a project, an employee, and the project, and this is representing the relation. Okay, so we have, this is the employee, this is the project, employee, project, employee, project, and this relationship is works on. Okay, so what is the cardinality of employee? It is N. And what is the participation of employee? It is 1. What is the cardinality of project? It is M. And what is the participation? Is 1. So the first representation is the cardinality ratio representation. Cardinality ratio representation. That means we are going to write this thing here and we are going to write this thing here. So you can see this becomes N ratio M, or you can say it is many to many relationship. Now, next is the single line double line representation. Single line double line. So what is the participation of employee? It is 1. And what is the participation of project? It is 1, because the participation is 1 in both the sides, therefore both the sides are in total participating condition. Both the sides are in total participation. And the last one is the min max representation. What is the minimum cardinality of employee? That is 1. And what is the maximum cardinality of employee? That is N. What is the minimum cardinality of project? That is 1. And what is the maximum cardinality? That is M. Right, so this is representing the many to many relationship. Okay.